Hey guys, welcome to the video. This is part one of the USS Oliver Hazard Perry build by Academy in 1/350 scale. I didn't originally want to break this up into as many two parts as I had to, but it's just for whatever reason my computer could not handle it. So anyways, you see right here we are cutting off the hull. For the Pontos kit specifically, I'm not sure this is for both of them, but I know for the one I have, this is for a long haul Oliver Hazard Perry class. So that's like the Halliburton, which I'm doing. I believe the McKinley is also, but like the later classes to allow for Seahawks. So the fit right here was not particularly good. It wasn't bad, it's just a little warping. I think this kit's a few years old at this point, so it's to be expected to have a little bit of, problems, fit issues, but for the most part, it went together pretty well. Nothing, like, totally, you know, detrimental to the model. It went together pretty well. I recommend putting in both the flight deck and the main deck when the glue has not set yet on the hull, just for structure. Rigidity with the structure, and also because you do not want the hull to kind of force itself to TP off, I guess is the way to put it, or like just make a triangle. You don't want those two halves to come in too far apart and then you have to pull apart the hull. As you can see here, that was not a great fit on there. Even when I took off this back part of the ship, it still wasn't a great fit. So it felt kind of like an afterthought. And here, this is like the first Pontos upgrade you'll see. So I tried to get a little experimental here with the editing. Tell me if you like it. I think it's a little different. I think it adds a little bit of flair to it. So right here, we are spray painting the tin canning, basically. I originally tried to go with black, see if it worked, but I don't think it captures it very well. I also tried doing it freehanded, which definitely didn't work, as you'll see that later on. But I think the problem with the black is that it's supposed to represent the tin canning. The way it works is it's the two pieces of steel, and then the steel put on top of it dips because there's nothing as the waves hit it. And so the ribs that are holding it up would not be darker, they'd be lighter, just based on the lighting, and the piece of steel that has concaved, would be darker. Hopefully that makes some sense. And right here you can see the whip antennas going in, and this was one of the main reasons I kind of wanted to get this kit, was because of all the antennas that come in as brass. Plastic ones over time seem to get brittler, and I have a cat that likes to walk over all my models for some reason, and so they snap off. But the brass ones, if they do snap, they're not going to snap in the middle, which is better. They're going to snap They're not going to snap in the middle. They'll snap at the bottom, which is better. And right here, we are cutting out the main structure to the mast. In all honesty, I would just go with the kit mast. It's perfectly fine. I also had a little bit of problem aligning the mast. I don't quite know what happened, but for whatever reason, I did. Apparently, it's not too uncommon. A few people I've seen talk about it, I've seen a few people talk about it. So, and this is what I have to say. This is where Pontos is kind of nice. I'm not sure if this is with it with all their other kits, but as you can see, this lattice type thing we're putting onto the like a part of the main mast. It is a two-dimensional piece. That's just one of them. Instead of putting on their side, if you can picture it, in just building a lattice like KA did for the Kitty Hawk, that was a pain in the butt, the KA one, but this one's nice. That's just, you put it on the bottom like that, and it simulates a some structure. And now right here, you'll see me kind of struggle to put these guys on. A kind of not a fault, I would say, but just like a little bit of a problem in the Pontos instructions. It could just be too, because I haven't used Pontos before. Some of it just didn't quite make sense until you put them on. So like originally, I had the other piece that's sticking out in towards the mast facing the other way. Alright guys, and I want to thank you so much for watching. I know your time is precious, so thank you for taking your time to watch this video. Hopefully I'll have part 2 out soon. I think I'll end up uploading both parts together at some point as one, but my computer could barely get through this video. So anyway, without taking any time left. Alright guys, and welcome back to part 2 of the Oliver Harris Perry build. And right away we are starting off with the decals. Now, this video, this is the dry transfers for the number 40. I think it came out okay, as you can see a little scratch right there. But yeah, they're fine, nothing special. And then right here, we are just cut out all of the, I don't know what these are, I guess vent holes for the main thing. Anyway, don't cut them out like I did. I lost a few, and you can see a few get crunched. It was easy enough to straighten the ones that got bent out, but it was harder to find the ones that were lost to the carpet monster. And this is definitely one of my favorite parts of the build, just from an aesthetic, it's aesthetically pleasing. This is the flag holder thing, that holds all the flags, you know, the NATO alphabet, the NATO phonic, or whatever they call it. It's just really nice looking with the graded floor, and the flag holders themselves look great. This is just a big upgrade from the kit. Thank you. right here we are finally getting some of the main superstructure bits in. As you can see, we already have the, I believe, 5-inch gun, and now we're getting the smokestack in, and now the 35-foot whip antennas. So it's finally all coming together. And I just wanted to thank you guys for watching this video. Sorry for the cut from this to the finished product. There just wasn't that much to show you. It was just putting in a bunch of railing, which was kind of tedious and annoying, and doing a few other things. So nothing that noticeable. But thank you guys for watching again. I know your time is valuable, so I'm glad you decided to watch this video. Anyway, I will see you in the next video. I think I'm going to do something either 700 scale or a USS Alaska class build in 350. So look out for that. I guess I'll let you know on like Instagram or whatever. So follow me and remember to like and subscribe. See you. Alright guys, what's going on? And thank you for watching up until this part. So this is kind of the final wrap-up conclusions. And I do have a fair amount to say, so this will be a little long. I just wanted to start off, first of all, with the kit itself. We're going to start with the hull. The hull was not that bad of a fit. It is a two-piece hull, as you saw in, or hopefully saw in the first video. However, if you are doing the Pontos one, which I believe both Pontos models are built for you to do the long haul version. There are two different types. The long haul, which you can see right here. And then this is the short haul, which is the Oliver Hazard Perry itself. But nothing really to complain there, except for that it was a little bit more than I thought it would be. I thought it'd be as simple as just gluing on the back and then putting it on the flight deck. However, it was a little bit different than that. Other than that, I tried painting the hull a little different. I did the standard tin canning. It's a little dusty. I did the standard tin canning that I normally do. I think I did a better job than I usually did. Jeez, it's a little dusty. I thought I did a better job than I usually did. I got a little bit closer to it. I tried doing a little bit more experimenting with the lower hull itself. Like, if you see pictures, you can see joins on the lower hull that are bigger, and you can see where rust will build up on the top and on the sides. So I tried doing that. I think it turned out okay. And then I tried spraying some cockpit green and some buff onto the lower hull. So the next thing I want to talk about is right here, as we keep on, I guess, working our way back. So there's two fins that are going in, and I haven't put them in yet because I'm not sure that the Halliburton had them. Now, the Halliburton
Now, some of them, I should say, not I'm not sure on the Halliburton. Some of them had kind of like fins, like rudder-shaped fins that would go right here. I'm not sure if the Halliburton was one of them. I'm gonna do some more research before I glue anything. I have not found anything definitive on them, but we'll see soon, I guess. what else? As you can see, that was not a great fit. I cannot for the life of me. Problem is that this didn't glue down very well, and so anytime that it moves, it seems to crack. I tried mitigating it, but it's not gonna work. I'm gonna try figuring something else, but from what I've seen, everybody's had a problem there. Some people, most people do it better than I did, but I just didn't think about that. I didn't watch any real builds before I built this, which is different than usual. So then I guess next, talk about the main superstructure, since we're on there. The main superstructure went together well. The Pontos deck is a nice touch because it gets rid of some of the stuff that you don't use in the later models. That's the great part about this Pontos kit, is it comes with Photo Etch for this little rocket launcher, or sorry, missile launcher, whatever it is, and then some of the older radar systems, like one that would go right here. However, since I'm doing this as a later year, like, I don't know, 2000, something like that, all those were removed by then. Yeah, so, and then, nicely enough, you do get a brass gun barrel for the main gun, which I've heard from people that it snaps all the time. So, mine didn't, but I decided to just go with it anyway. And then there's the Phalanx gun, which I wish it came with just some photo etch. Just something, but it didn't. But the their advanced set, what they call it, comes with a resin one. So that's nice enough. The main mast, I had problems with this main mast. I think I talked about it in the last video. It's entirely on my fault. I should have paid a little bit more attention to it. But I thought they were all four of the same legs. They are not. As you can see, it's canted to the bow quite a bit. It should be facing towards, or it should be leaning towards the stern. I painted it. It's really showing up pretty pink in my camera for whatever reason, but it's not this. It's pretty gray. And a little gold. I don't know what's going on there. Anyway, it's gray. To me, it's like a little just pinker than the other gray that I've been using. The radar went together very nicely. Everything went together very nicely. There's no real major fit issues except for that, which is on both sides. Other than that, this is a pretty good build. I do like the use of dry transfers. I thought they were a nice touch. However, I wish they came with dry transfers for these markings. They're a little bit thick. They look okay now, but they are a little bit thick. And then lastly, I guess I should talk about, is I decided to paint the squadron for this build as HS6, the Screaming Indians. I decided to leave the doors off. I couldn't quite get them to look right. Even in styrene, they just look too thick, so I'm just going to leave them off. It's not going to be accurate, but oh well. Yeah, other than that, it went together very well. This is a trumpeter one. So it used the photo etch landing gear, and that's it. Yeah. So thank you guys for watching. I wanted to keep this somewhat brief. I could probably go on a longer tangent about it, but I don't want to take up your precious time. So thank you guys for watching so much. I will see you guys in the next video. I don't know what that will be, but hopefully something interesting. So see you guys then. Peace.
Gary! I was just looking for the sports channel, Gary.